H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Cool. So now we have a condition here where we can do what? We can actually have a if statement. We have nested if statement. We have else statement. Else also have if statement. So such a complicated code always exists. Okay. So there is no denying the fact that we have simple things. Okay. So never. You're always going to have complicated things. But sometimes what happens is you have particular conditions to work on. So here we are taking a practical example. Okay, so I'm creating, and I'm keep doing that in day two itself. Okay, so I'm not creating a new package today. So you say store batch runner application. So this is store batch and run application basically, or I'll just say store batch runner. So what exactly this application means, what exactly the application do is whenever store opens, okay, it actually executes the batch. What this batch do is it takes the latest prices from the corporate. Okay, so the sole purpose of the batch is to take the prices. Now thing is, I do not know when the store is opening, right? Now the store opening timings are dependent on the day of the week. The day of the week is basically, as you know, it's Monday to Sunday, right? So a store opens every day. Okay, there is nothing like store is closed today, right? So now every day I have a different timing to open the store depending on my market demands, right? So in Monday I open at 7:30 in the morning because people start early. So if they want to grab anything from the store in early morning, they can do that. Tuesday though, it's a delayed day. Okay, so I'm starting at 8. Okay, so you write down stuff. So here I have something called Monday, and then Monday I start at 7:30. Okay, then on Tuesday, just like multi-line comment. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, I open at 8:30. Again, like Friday, I know that people start early and leave early, so I can go back to 7:30 time. Saturday is a lazy day, so I'll start at 8 o'clock in the morning. Sunday is again like a lot of people do grocery shopping at that day, but Sunday is also a lazy day. Nobody gonna stop me at 7:30, so I'm gonna putting it at 9 o'clock. So every day there is a different time when my store opens, and at different time my store batch runner is actually initiating the batch. How do I do that? How do I manage these conditions? Now I have to write a if condition, like if the day is Monday, okay, then trigger the batch at 7:30, okay, and then Tuesday and all those. So how do we trigger at 7:30? That's a different prospect altogether. But handling these many conditions, okay, and how many if conditions we are dealing with, this is really funny part, isn't that true? So how do we handle that? And we do that with the help of something called a switch case. So switch case is used particularly for such scenarios. So we call it as day of week. Okay, so I'll declare a variable called as integer day of week. Okay. And Monday being, let me think it through. So hold on, what happened to my Eclipse? Monday being either 0 or 1. Okay, sorry. Let's see. So Monday should be, okay, Sunday should be 1. Okay, so I'm taking it from a class, okay, a particular class in Java, okay, which will help me to do it. So Sunday is 1. Okay, so we'll talk about that class also. So Sunday is 1, and then accordingly Monday is 2. Okay, and it goes on. So day of the week is actually specifying that particular day in the number format. Okay, so whether it's a Sunday, Monday, which one is day, which day is today? So it's Tuesday, so basically it's 2, right? So day of the week is 2. Right, it will be dynamic, Don't worry about that. We'll take the value dynamically. Now we have to write conditions, right? So we write it with the help of switch case. So it will say switch off day of the week. Okay. And in that, you're going to write different condition for different days. So you say, now the case when the day of the week is one. Okay. So this is case number one. And then you're going to write a case for that. Okay. So you will see that this is the case for day of the week when day of the week value is one. Okay, so what's the value when day of the value is one is basically Sunday. So you say switch out start store batch 9 a.m. Right? Any questions up to this point? Extra. Cool. So now the second case will be when the day of the week is 2, 3, and 4 and all those. So we'll continue to do that. So now day of the week is 2, that is Monday. I have the batch at 7:30. Now for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, I had 8:30. So again, I have like 3, then 4, and 5 wait to be declared. Okay, and then specify the exact same time. Do I have to do that? No, you don't have to do that. What you say is the case of 3, 4, and 5 basically share the same stuff. Okay, so you don't write it this way. You write case of 3. Okay, then you write case of 4. And in case of 5, exactly point to the same block of code. Okay, which is opening the store at 8:30. Right? Then Friday at 7:30. So 7:30 is here also. So you can say case of 2 and case of 6 is the same. Isn't that true? So Friday and Monday, you are starting at 7:30, and now finally you have case of 7. So you have case of 7, which is at 8 o'clock. Okay, so this complete your switch case. Align it properly. So now isn't that awesome, or isn't that look good that you handle it this way, right? Now, can we actually do that? Why integer day of the week 2? What's the logic? I wrote the logic. Sunday is 1. Sunday is 1, Monday is 2, Tuesday is. So Sunday is 1, Monday is 2, Tuesday is 3. Whichever, like day of the week is just an integer. It's like 7 days, right? So we are just testing it that way. Okay. It is just to invoke the case. Yes, it is just to invoke the case. You are right. Absolutely right. Okay, so now you can see that basically this particular case, now when 3, basically you are getting 8:30, when 2 you are getting 7:30. So test it 2. Okay, suppose today is Monday. So what you are going to do is you are going to start batch at 7:30. Okay, so let's start and execute the code and see if that works. Good with it? So what will happen? Your integer day of the week is basically 2. So it will come here, switch off 2. So it will go to case 2, it will print this line, and you are done. Right? So after switch case is done, we are just printing a line. Okay, so I'll just switch out here that end of switch case statement. I just wrote that, okay? Just to keep us informed. Nice. Go and run. Then as Java application. Should get result in the console. So I got this. This is good point. It is a good start when day of week is 2. So I'm jumping to case 2. I'm printing 7:30. I'm good up to this point. What happened next? I printed 8:30. I printed 8, and then I'm printing end of case statement. That means I'm entering it a proper value, but I'm not exiting it. I'm following it through the ladder. That's not right. That's not something is intended. You have to jump out of the ladder, okay, directly to end of the switch case statement. So you need to add something called as break. So break is helpful in this scenario. So break statement is jumping out of the ladder. Once you execute this line of code, you are done, right? So break. Now you add a break in every case. It's very important, every case. So now let's see if you get an appropriate result. So run this and you get start the store batch at 7:30 and end of the switch case. Now this is logical. Now what happens is my data is somehow came in a way that my day of the week came as 8. Okay, my day of the week is came as 8. Okay, of course that was a mistake. Okay, I'm not saying it's true, but at that particular day my batch didn't run. Isn't it true? By some mistake, okay, it came at 8. What happened? End of switch case statement. So there is no batch trigger at all. That is a bad thing. So because I do not have a case for 8, what happened? Actually, I missed that particular batch. So to handle such scenarios when none of the cases matches, you can add something called as default. So if none match, at least do this. Okay. So this will be default case. Okay, and then you can add something into it. So most common and most best time is 8 o'clock. Okay, so even if you are opening at 7:30 on that day, at least you are just half an hour delayed. Okay, so we are not too early, we are not too late. So by default it's 8 o'clock. Okay, so this is what we are going to do. So now handle the scenario, execute this line of code, see what happens. Even if the value is 8, basically you gonna execute the store batch as between 8 a.m. You do not need, so default is generally a last case, and you do not need break statement because it's the last step in the ladder. Okay, so where are you jumping anyway? You are going to jump out of it anyway, right? So break is definitely not required, but even if you add it, nobody can actually screw you and put it in the jail. So you can add it, no problem with that, right? That's a switch case. Now switch case can be switched on either characters, strings and integers. So you can use character for switching, you can use strings for switching, and you can definitely use integer and his brothers, like brother, what are the brothers? Byte and short, right? You can use that also for switching. Okay, ultimately it's going to convert that into integer and then use it. Okay, so that's a different story altogether, but that is a switch case for you. Okay, so let's see the rules. So switch, so rules apply for switch case. So variables using switch statement can only be byte, short, int and character, and strings also. So strings are also allowed. You can have any number of case statements within switch. Okay, each case is followed by the value to be compared, okay, and a colon. Okay, we saw that value to be compared. Okay, so this is like 8, so 8 to be compared. Why can't we use, it's not actually coded that way. Why can't we do that? I can't answer that. Okay, somebody who wrote Java did that way. Okay, it is not like taking float and double. Okay, it takes integer, short, byte, and strings and characters. Okay, it need definite value values. So value for a case must be same data type as the variable in the switch. Okay, it must be constant or the literal. So basically you cannot like create a string literally a string here and then switch on integers. Okay, that is ridiculous. Like, where exactly you are comparing them, right? So that is the point here. When a variable being switched on is equal to the case, that will happen. It will execute that up to break is written. How about byte and integer? Well, byte is allowed. I told it byte, short, int or character is written there. Okay, when a break statement is reached, okay, the switch terminates and the flow control jump to the next line of switch case. Not every case needs to contains a break. Okay, but if no, so see, break is not mandatory, remember that. Compiler didn't complain at that time also when we didn't have break, right? So break is something which you specify when you don't want to fall through the ladder. Okay. If you want to, then nobody can stop you. Right. So if no break appears, then the flow control will fall through the subsequent cases until break is reached. Okay. A switch statement can have an optional default. Okay. Yeah, optional default case. So default case, okay, which is like when none of the case matches, it's gonna execute that. Okay, no break is needed for default case. If you pass byte, it will automatically get converted into integer and it will be used as an integer. Okay, that's why I said byte and short are allowed. Okay, only younger brothers of integers are allowed because they can automatically get converted into integer and used by instead. That is called auto boxing. Okay, that happens. Not that actually not called auto boxing or auto boxing as it is, but yes, it's similar way. How often we use case in real time? I gave you a really real time example which we used to use like 4 years back. Okay, so this was a kind of thing we actually coded for one of the batches, not exactly for pricing, but we definitely used it for one of the purpose. When as soon as the store opens, we used to refresh some data. Okay, so that data refresh happens at different time and different days. Okay, so that's why I gave you a practical example of that. Okay. That was for paste by. Okay. Now we'll come back to loops. Okay, I actually wanted to start loops yesterday itself. So in Java, we have three types of loops. But first thing is, what is looping? So loop is nothing but like we have certain set of statements and we want to repeat the execution of this set of statements, okay, number of times. The number of times can be fixed one, okay, or number of times can be dependent on certain conditions. Okay, so there can be a Boolean expressions and I'm waiting for that Boolean expressions to come true, go false. So until that is that Boolean expression is true, I'm going to execute a block of code. As soon as it goes false, I'm done. Okay, that is one way where I do not know how many times I'm iterating. Okay, and second thing is, if I know how exactly I'm iterating for which value, okay, then that is another type of loops. Okay, so there are two types of loops, where one is I am dependent on a condition, one is I know where to start and where to end. So the first one, where I do not know or I'm dependent on a condition, are basically while loop and do while loop. Okay, so while loop depends on a Boolean expression. If Boolean expression is true, then the statement in the while loop executes and it will again check the Boolean expression. If it again true, then again executes the block of code. It again checks that and it goes on until the Boolean expression comes out as false. As soon as it is false, then the statement execution stops and it will come out of the loop. Okay. So before that, we're going to take a simple example. Okay. To understand. Now here I'm going to create a package 3.